greeting you as we gather in St Nicholas Church for Beki and Ray's wedding ceremony. It's good to see you on this sunny afternoon. I noticed that Beki and Ray both have good men on either side of them, and it's lovely that you're here to witness the vows which are taken in the service in this very special place of worship, which has been here for hundreds of years and has seen many ceremonies of joy and thanksgiving, just as such is the one that we celebrate today with Beki and with Ray. We wish you very well in your vows and in your lives together. I'm going to read an opening prayer, for which please remain standing. God of wonder and of joy, grace comes from you, and you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts and serve you always with willing minds. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Let us all join together in singing.
First of all, for those of you, those drivers amongst you, let me first of all say that I gather you're not expected to pay the car parking fees, so I'm not quite sure how you avoid it. You need to perhaps just talk to reception when you leave and sort it. Anyway, right, as I say, good evening. Welcome to all of you this evening. Very pleased to see you all and see you with us tonight to share in this joyous occasion with Beki and Ray. There is, of course, one person not here tonight. For those of you who didn't know her, that's Kathy, Becky's mum, who passed away 3.5 years ago. I'm sure, like myself, she would have been very proud of Beki this afternoon. I'm also sure she would have been very pleased with Becky's choice of husband, and she would have been only too pleased to welcome Ray into the family, as indeed am I. I'm sure, I think they probably shared a wacky sense of humour. To repeat Beki's words to me earlier on this week, she was sure that Kathy, her mum, would have been in her element today. And I'm sure she would. Because if nothing else, what she really liked was a good family get together and the knees up. I'll try and keep this fairly brief if I can, mercifully brief, mercifully for you and mercifully for me. However, sorry, I lost my thread
now. Look at the notes, help.
We all know of the popularity of June weddings, I would say. Most of you probably think that June weddings are pretty popular. But I wonder if any of you really thought about why. Is it because it's nice weather? Who knows? Well, I've come up with, well, actually Mary came up with the probable answer for that, which is this, and I'll quote. It's called loving aroma. Summer weddings are popular now, with brides hoping to bask in the sun. But 500 years ago, a June wedding was for more practical reasons. Most people got married in June because they took their yearly bath in May. And still smelled pretty good by June. And the bouquet brides still carry today? Well, that was to hide the pong that was just starting to develop.
It's a good one.
I hasten to add, in case any of you are wondering, I did have a bath last month, so you're
all right then.
That was a good one, Al.
One thing that Kathy had a great passion for was cross-stitch. And that's something she shares with Mary, my partner now. And I would just like to present this to Beki and Ray, for them to hang on the wall. If you'd like to unwrap that, Beki. And I'd like to thank Mary for a lot of hard work and a lot of time that's gone into this.
Just rip
the paper. Just work there. And next time I come down to Luton Road, I would hope to see it hanging on the wall.
Oh, that is wonderful. Alan, right. Ask him to hold it up a bit, yeah?
We'll go around there next.
Come on.
Do you want to hold that between you and Ray?
Stay there, Ray.
You might need to stand up.
Get in there, Alan.
Cool.
Turn around, Ray.
So, as I say, amazing.
Yeah, that is amazing.
So I would ask you all now to join me in wishing Beki and Ray many long years of happiness in their life together. So I'd like to propose a toast to Beki and Ray.
Beki and Ray. Right, big boy.
I'd like to thank Alan for his very kind words. And like him, I've got a brain like a sieve, so I can smile out.
Sieve, yeah.
So actually, got two whole pages, so I'm glad you're eating already.
The beer to midnight.
June 14th, 2006, that's my posting. It seems like just yesterday, over the past year, we have enjoyed planning on the wedding. Look forward to seeing all of you come share this time.
First time I've ever known him ask for words.
Go for it.
Beki and I have been looking forward to this day for a long, long time. I can't tell you how pleased we are for it, to be able to share this with you, all of you, for coming for such a short distance. Thank you very much. There have been so many people we'd love to thank. Some have been mentioned already by Alan. I'd like to go briefly through some of that right now. I'd like to thank again once for everyone for attending. We also like to thank for the cards of kind thoughts and very nice gifts. Thank you very much. I'm going to spend them on PS3 when we get back.
Typical.
Where am I? But most of all, we'd like to thank for all the smiley faces that probably appear in front of us. Thank you very much. I'll try and get this brief as well for my own good as well. Right, families. We'd like to pay tribute to our respective families for all they have done. They have been our biggest cheerleaders without the outfit. Your support and encouragement is much appreciated. Each of you has contributed significantly to our happiness, and we would also like to thank you. Thank our grandparents, uncles and aunts who have supported us with their prayers from heaven. We all know that you are here in person or in spirit and will be down tonight away with us. I'd like to thank you, Alan, for your kind words earlier again. Also for your large donations, which make this all possible. I am proud to be your son-in-law. I hope I can live up to your expertise.
Expectations. We got that wrong.
Most of all, thank you for giving me your blessing to marry Beki, even though it was after the pose, but hey, I'm back. Thank you to you, Catherine, who I know is here in spirit. You have raised the woman of my dreams. I'm honoured to finally be part of the family. Mum and Dad. I'm Indian. First of all, Mum, looking stunning. Dad,
Yeah, I got a toy on for one.
Didn't want to leave you out. But seriously, there was so much I'd like to thank you for. Thank you both for which you have heartily welcomed Beki into the family. Both of you have prepared me very well, you've taught me the difference between right and wrong, you've supported me through my youth, through my life, been by my side for everything I've gone through. Most importantly, you both showed me the true meaning of loyalty, kindness and unconditional love. You both continue to be role models to me, and I have always been towers of, no mate, you've been all towers of my strength. There is no better man than you, Dad. Mum,
you're best. Appreciate it.
Also, like to thank Shah and Shana for keeping Beki calm and got some gifts.
No, but he's doing well.
Take.
He's run off. Max, he's run off.
Did anyone touch the golden chains or not?
He'll be back.
The same pilot plan, by the way.
You're right, you normally lost for words.
Thank you, Beki.
I did a lot of guys, all right.
I'll put them there.
Ashes, best, thank you, Darren and Matt. Stand up. I could have picked a better pair of you guys to be me today, Ashes. It's also helped a lot, helpful to know that I wasn't the only one wearing best, top hand tail. So I kind of shared that.
Never seen a 6 foot penguin.
Hello, so, best man. Thanks to my best man Tony, my brother Tony, who won't be embarrassing me in a few moments. My brother, who I shared fun times with, forgettable memories with me, along with other brothers, Darren and Marty. Four boys. How did you cope? just to finish it off, both parents, yeah, we'd like to thank you once again, as we wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for you then. Could not have had such a perfect day without your love, kindness, and financial support. Like to take a toast. But at least, but not last. At least, not last. No, wait. Last, not least.
They're trying to come 3 days.
First, I'm lucky.
What is it?
How many
all your kind words and honour of my family and friends. I was told how beautiful. You're very, very beautiful. To Beki.
Well done, son. I bet you're glad that's over. Apparently not.
I'm trying to keep it
simple. My turn.
You can have some. Right. Right.
Where are you going?
Get over there, boy.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
He's crazy.
First of all, I'd like to thank everyone for being here today. To win this wedding of Ray and Beki. And I'd also like to say that you look very lovely indeed. So thank you very much. Right then, where shall I begin? In case you didn't know, Ray first met Beki at Toys R Us about 3-4 years ago.
24 years.
We're friends for quite a long time until Ray built enough courage to ask Beki to be his girlfriend. Oh, bless. Um,
Where's that?
You're lost now.
But there are a few things I wanted to share with you about Ray. Today, friends and family will regard Ray as a lovely, pleasant, caring person who will always put everyone before himself, which is fair enough. But what you all don't know was when Ray was younger, he was a little terror. Wasn't he, Mum? And trust me to say this, I was his younger brother, so I know firsthand what he's like. I mean, he was so bad that Mum had to dye her hair, as you can all tell, so.
Oh, I can see you got riding.
Yeah. I mean, where to begin? Slamming doors, shouting. Actually, no, that was probably me first, but then I encouraged them, so yeah, that's fair.
When? You hold that and just keep it on it.
But to be honest, I would love to stand here and tell you all the shocking stories about when I was younger, but we're probably here to bow down and get married. And believe me, that could take a few years, so we'll have to wait for that. But if you want any of the gossip, just see my mum, she'll be happy to tell you.
Got it all on tape.
Or DVD.
But in fairness, and speaking on behalf of me and the rest of my brothers, Ray is a brother that has done so much for us. He's always making us laugh and always making me feel like we can depend on him. Ray's never heard the word sleep, as you can all imagine. But I know a lot of me and a lot of other people love to sleep, so just let everyone know. At work, he's always working hard, taking care of everyone. And his favourite, which is, of course, kicking annoying little kids out, which Ray likes to do best. It is very easy to like Ray, but very hard to hate him. Unless you're his brother, of course, but I'm only joking, so you know. But I would like to end the speech by everyone standing up and giving a toast to two lovely, caring people. To two lovely people who joined together in marriage. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mr. and Mrs. Sivia.
Mr. and Mrs. Sivia. Hello.
Hey.
Well done, sir.
That's a lovely speech, by the way.
Sounds good.
Sorry.